In June 1906, the world seemed to pour into America. Over a million immigrants would enter the U.S. this year. Every day, 2,000 newcomers were admitted from Ellis Island. As the numbers grew, so did some Americans' concern about which immigrants were allowed to enter and, more important, allowed to vote. Until now, any state could grant citizenship to immigrants. Under the new Naturalization Act, only the federal government had the right to grant citizenship using one standard procedure. The new law didn't change everything, though. It kept the 1790 rule that restricted citizenship to white immigrants only. It added another restriction, too. All citizens had to speak English. June was a big month for history-making laws. On the 30th, Congress passed the Meat Inspection Act. For years, reformers had been telling Americans about the filthy conditions in stockyards and how meat was often contaminated and spoiled meat was sold after being treated with formaldehyde. The Meat Inspection Act required meat packers to clean up their plants. It also put government inspectors at every point in meat production and required companies to dispose of all soiled and rotten foods instead of trying to sell them. The same day, the Pure Food and Drug Act was signed into law. It banned many food adulterants and required manufacturers to list all the ingredients on their products. The law was especially hard on the producers of patent medicines. They were now forced to reveal that their remedies were spiked with alcohol, cocaine, or morphine, in addition to other chemicals that produced no effect at all. But even these momentous laws couldn't compete with the lead story of the day. It concerned Evelyn Nesbit, a famous model who many saw as representative of the modern American woman. After she turned Broadway actress, Nesbit caught the attention of famed architect Stanford White. They began an affair that lasted several months. When it was over, she began seeing Harry Kendall Thaw, the dissolute and unbalanced heir to a fortune. Thaw developed an obsessive hatred of White after learning of Nesbit's previous affair with him. Eventually, he married Nesbit, but he couldn't let go of his rage against White. On June 25th, White was in a crowd watching a musical being staged on the roof of Madison Square Garden, a building he himself had designed. Thaw walked up to White and shot him 3 times, exclaiming to the crowd, "I did it because he ruined my wife." News of the subsequent trial became the lead story in newspapers for months, particularly when Nesbit recounted the details of her affair with White. The story had everything: sex, seduction, misbehaving celebrities, the corruption of an innocent, insanity, and murder. The trial resulted in a hung jury. The retrial found Thaw not guilty by reason of insanity. The trial was oddly representative of America in the new century. 3 new laws had been passed that would have profound effects on Americans' lives. But the nation's attention was riveted on the trial and the day's top celebrities. This video is brought to you by the Saturday Evening Post Digital Archives. Saturday Evening Post members can explore our 200-year-old archive and receive 6 issues of the Post print edition for only $15 a year. Subscribe today at the link below.